of the road. A young lion do suffer and go hungry, but them that seek the Lord lack nothing good. And nothing good will I withhold from them that love me. And God is that spirit. And where the spirit of God is, there is liberty. I was young and now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Prophesy over your life. You know, today, whatever you do with your heart, it shall prosper. Whatever brought you down, whatever put you down, allow money to catch fire.
I prophesy over your life, over the life of your children, you shall never burn. As long as you're not dead, there's hope for you tomorrow.
Your Alpha,
Alpha,
Omega, yeah.
The Lord, I thank God for you and I thank God for your life, for his blessing, his glory and his manifestation. This is Reverend Bernard Akama. I'm the senior pastor of Sound of Abundance Church, and the Lord has been gracious to us in our church. We have a department called Ladies Department, means the Lord's ministry. It's a department of women whereby in a month of August every year they go out for outreach, and so this month has not been different. They have been out there doing evangelism and outreaches by the grace of God, and this Sunday is the culmination of the entire outreach week month. And so we are having our celebration service, which I want to welcome you to it. Hear me. Anytime you celebrate, it's a sign expecting God to do something. Because celebration precedes manifestation. When you celebrate, three things happen. Either God has done something good, God is going to do something good, and something good is took place. That's what the Bible says, rejoice all ye, the ye lamb, because the Lord has done wondrous things with you. So I want you to join us for this wonderful service as I teach on this subject on celebration. And after that, I know good things are going to take place. God bless
you.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Today is our celebration service.
Amen.
And I want to bring the word of God briefly because I want us to celebrate. Glory to God.
Amen.
When we talk about celebration, we are talking about jubilation. And when we talk about jubilation, we are talking about jubilee, meaning the day of freedom. Anytime you talk about jubilation, you cannot put far deliverance, because the Bible says they were told that in the day of jubilee you shall release all the slaves. So anywhere you see jubilation or celebration, it's a sign somebody has been delivered.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
I decree to you, today is the day of your deliverance. Jubilation or celebration means gladness and rejoicing. Anywhere there is jubilation, there is rejoicing. There is gladness. Because celebration always precedes manifestation. Anywhere you see celebration, there must be manifestation. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
So, celebration always manifests something. And so, when you start to celebrate, God is ready to manifest. Are you hearing me? Anywhere there is celebration, it means God is ready to do something. God wants to manifest. Joel chapter 2. Go there with me very fast. Joel chapter 2, verse number 21. Fear not, O land. Be glad and rejoice. Be glad and celebrate. He say, fear not, O Akama. Celebrate. Jubilate. Rejoice. Why? For the Lord has done marvelous things. Do not be afraid, you beasts of the field.
For the open pastures are springing up, and the trees bear its fruits. Aha! The fig tree and the vine yield their strength. So anywhere there's jubilation, there must be fruitfulness. There must be increase. There must be open pasture. In other words, open check. Glory to God. Then he says, the trees will produce in their strength. Meaning every tree, and tree grows from the ground. Now look at verse 23. Be glad, you children of Sons of Abundance.
Amen.
And rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given you the former rain faithfully, and he will cause the rain to come down for you. For who? Now rain is the sign of what? Blessing. Ezekiel 34:26. And I will cause upon my hills to be rain, and there shall be showers of blessing. So rain is a symbol of blessing. So where there is celebration, there must be what? Blessing. I see blessings for you from today.
Amen.
That the amen is standing with one leg.
Amen.
24. He says, the threshing floor shall be full of wheat, and the vats shall overflow with new wine and oil. Then, so I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust, my great army which I sent among you. You shall eat in what? You shall eat in what? Look at your Bible. You shall eat in what? So when there is celebration, there is plenty. He said you shall eat in plenty and be what? And be satisfied. Then what? Then praise the name of the Lord your God. For he has done what?
Wonders.
Wonders. So anywhere there's celebration, there's manifestation of wonders. That your amen is annoying me.
Amen.
So anyone that enters into a season of celebration, it means the person is ready to eat in plenty.
Amen.
That is why Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord. And again I say, rejoice. So celebration is rejoicing in the Lord. Why should I rejoice? Am I talking to you? It is celebration that sets the pace for the next manifestation. When you want to see the next breakthrough, start celebrating. Amen. It is celebration. It is rejoicing that, or celebration, it is that that sets the pace for the next manifestation. When you are rejoicing, it means God is going to do something. God is going to do what? Something. Exodus 18:7 says what? Pastor Eric, be fast.
So Moses went out to meet his
father. So Moses went out to meet his father.
Bowed down.
And kissed him.
And they asked each other about their well-being.
About their well-being.
And they went into the tent.
Read on.
And Moses told his father-in-law all that the Lord had done.
All that the Lord had done.
To Pharaoh. And to the Egyptians.
Read on.
For Israel's sake. All the hardship. That had come upon them.
Yes.
On the way. And how the Lord had delivered them.
Then Jethro.
Rejoice. For all the good
the Lord had done
for Israel. Whom he had delivered out of the hand of the Egyptians.
Anytime you celebrate, it's because God is doing something, or he has done something, or is about to do something. So there's no celebration without some manifestation. So if God has done nothing, start celebrating for you to do something.
Amen.
Because it is celebration that makes God to do something.
Amen.
going to bat on the mount of Tekoa. As they were going up, they began to sing, "The Lord is good, and His mercy endure forever." They were dancing, "The Lord is good." The army against them is 5 times bigger. 5 nations against 1 nation. But they are dancing, "The Lord is good and His mercy." 1 nation, less than 10,000 people. And the other team had 10,000 in every army. So they were meeting over 50,000 people. 1 army, which was not even up to 1,000. But they are jubilating. "The Lord is good." And the Lord set an ambushment. Anytime you want God to do something, start celebrating. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Am I talking to you? When you want to die tomorrow, start mourning. Start complaining. You will die tomorrow. God removes food from your mouth when you complain.
Yes.
But when you thank God and you rejoice in the Lord, He adds unto you. Am I communicating here?
Yes.
Hey, why should I celebrate? One, because the Lord has blessed thee. Why should I jubilate? Why should I celebrate? Because the Lord has blessed you. Tell your neighbor, "I am blessed."
I am blessed.
So why should I celebrate? The Lord has blessed me. Am I talking to somebody here? Deuteronomy chapter 12, verse 7.
And there, you shall eat before the Lord your God.
Read like an evangelist now.
And there, you shall eat before the Lord your God. And you shall rejoice.
And you shall rejoice
in all to which you have put your hand. You and your household, in which the Lord your God has blessed you.
In which the Lord your God has done what? So He said you rejoice because first you ate.
Yeah.
And two, the Lord bless the works of your hand. Meaning what? When I celebrate, God will bless the works of my hand. Number two, why should I celebrate? Because of every good thing the Lord has given me. You should celebrate because of the every good thing the Lord has given to you. Am I talking to you? Every good thing. When God gives you a good voice like Jesus, thank God. God gives you a wonderful child, thank God. Deuteronomy 26. Tell your neighbor, "The Lord has given me something." He has given you good things. Genesis, Deuteronomy 26, verse number 11. Says what?
So you shall rejoice in every good
thing. In every good thing.
Which the Lord your God has given to you and your house.
Your house?
You and the Levite and the stranger who is among you.
He said you shall rejoice in every good thing. For every good and pleasant gift comes from the Lord. So when the Lord has given you something good, you rejoice. It is not easy to pack 1,000 in your wallet. When you have it, rejoice. So what is this? Some of you, because you're not appreciating the little, God can't give you much.
Amen.
You can't appreciate. So what is this? What is this? God said, even the little that you have shall be taken from you.
Mm.
Number three, why should I rejoice? Because you rejoice in your going out, knowing you will not return empty. You rejoice because as I leave my house, I will not come back empty. Now, this is how you get the blessings of the day. Because Bible says, "The Lord be magnified, who daily loads us with benefit." Now, every day carry benefit. We should be happy going out. Bible says, "Blessed shall thou be when you come in and when you go out." Now, Deuteronomy 33, verse number 18. 33 verse 18. Says what?
And of Zebulun,
he said,
Rejoice,
Zebulun,
in your going out.
In your going out.
And Issachar, in your tent.
In your tent. He said, Zebulun, as you're going out, rejoice. Do you know why you leave your house and you come back broke? Because you are not rejoicing when you're going out. Because God said, "Blessed shall thou be when you go out and when you come back." So, what determines what you come back with is your rejoicing when you're going out. Before you enter enter your office in the morning, in your house, take 5 minutes, rejoice. That one will make the day to produce for you. It's a rejoice chaperone in your going out. Why? Because you have a revelation. I am blessed in the city and I'm blessed in the country. So as long as you know and I leave my house, I will not come empty. When you rejoice in that, you see it. Tell them I'm blessed. Tell them I'm blessed. I am giving you secrets to enjoy blessings every day. Number four, why should I rejoice? Should rejoice because of your enemies. God has given you the neck of your enemies. Second Chronicles 20:27. Says what?
Then they returned.
Every man of Judah.
And Jerusalem. With Jehoshaphat in front of them. To go back to Jerusalem with joy. For the Lord had made them rejoice over their enemies.
The Lord had made them rejoice over who?
Their enemies.
Over who?
Their enemies.
Over who?
Their enemies.
So when you want to see your enemies crash, start rejoicing. Yeah. They are talking bad about you, be happy. Start laughing. And you hate me. See how God will deal with them. Some of you, I don't like you. Oh God. What kind of rejection is this? We are rejoice. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Number five. Why should I rejoice? Because the Lord has helped you. It is not of him that ran it or him that will it, but of God that showed mercy. So God showed you mercy and he helped you. Rejoice. Do you know Reverend Akama to be in sound of a banner city center? It is not my grace. It is the help of God.
Amen.
It is the help of who? Oh. To move people from Mati River to come to town on a Sunday and they were here from Monday to Saturday. There's the hand of God.
Yes, sir.
Did you know so?
Yes.
Some of you, you love sleep. Sunday is your day of sleeping. You still came. It's not because of any heavy anointing. It's God helping me. Now, the problem is this. When God is helping you, you reject it. Saying, it's not God. Anytime you cannot see the help of God, God will do it.
Yeah.
One time I was feeling sleepy. I wanted to pray. On Saturday, I felt sleepy. I told God, excuse me. Let me go to bed. After all, the charge is not my charge. The charge is your bride. Oh, yeah, give me blanket. Entered blanket. Slept. Woke up at 7:30 feeling guilty. I came to church. Power moved. It's not by might. It's by my spirit, said the Lord. So anytime you think it's yourself that is getting the money, you are erring. You are missing it. This money is because of my hand. God will chop them off. It is because of the help of Jehovah. If you're able to feed your mouth, it's the help of Jehovah. If your husband is kissing you here, kissing your head, kissing your nose, the help of Jehovah. He can decide to kiss tree. Decided to kiss you. It's the help of Jehovah. Psalms 28 verse 7 says what?
The Lord is my strength.
The Lord is my strength.
And my shield. My heart trusted in him. And I am helped.
I am what? Trust in him, he helps me. Abba. Psalm 63:11 says what?
But the king
shall rejoice in God.
Everyone who swears by him shall glory.
Number six, why should I jubilate or celebrate? Because for great shall be your reward. When you celebrate, God rewards you. I'm not talking here. Matthew 5:12.
Rejoice and be exceedingly glad. For great is your reward.
For great is your reward.
In heaven.
So when you are happy, when you're celebrating, great is your reward in heaven. Not only on earth, where? So if on earth you cannot rejoice, do you think heaven you'll be able to rejoice? Now this is what I don't understand with people. I'm going to heaven to do what? What are you doing? Go to do there? The way you're gloomy, the way you're scary. Happy, happy! Rejoice! Because great is your reward. Papa, tell your neighbor, my reward is great. How do I rejoice? For three things. How do I rejoice? Then I close. How do I rejoice? Number one, by singing aggressive praises, vengeful praises, fearful praises. Exodus 15:11. Who is like unto thee, O God? Who is like unto thee among the gods? Fearful in praises, doing wonders. When you are praiseful, you are lifted. You cannot praise the Most High and remain the Most Low. I repeat, you cannot praise the Most High and remain the Most Low. It's not possible. Because when you praise God who is on high, then he said in Deuteronomy 28:1, and you shall hearken to the Lord thy God to keep all his commandments and statutes, then the Lord will set you high above all the nations of the earth, and this blessing shall come upon you and overtake you. So do you want to go up? Philippians 2:2, for we are seated with Christ far above. So I am seated on top. Sorry, but I'm on top. Psalm 9:2 says what?
I will be glad and rejoice in you.
I will be glad and rejoice in you.
I will sing praise.
I will sing praises in what?
Almost high.
Verse 14. Rejoicing is accompanied by praise. So neighbor, I want to dance today.
I want to celebrate.
There's a way you celebrate. If you're pregnant, baby, say, I'm coming tomorrow.
Yeah.
At your thing, they say, I'm told I'm a love buyer. You just shake it. Shake it. The baby will turn. And tell mama, I understand. So when I'm told I'm a love buyer, I have an idea. Oh. Shake it. Shake it. Shake it. You just shake it, it'll happen. Verse 14 says what?
That I may tell you of your praise.
That I may tell you of your what?
Of your praise.
Of your praise.
In the gates of the daughter of Zion.
In the gates of the daughter of Zion.
I will rejoice in
I
your
will
salvation.
I will rejoice in the salvation. So there's no rejoicing without praise. The neighbor about to praise. Psalms 33:1. Praise. I love your name. Praise. If you don't praise, you cannot be raised. If you don't pray, you cannot be praying. Some people, like me, I love worship more. Look at your life. Sad. Full of wahala. Oh yeah, learn to sing. Sometimes in your house, just be mad. Answer madness with madness.
Amen.
Say, this problem is mad. It's not leaving me. Okay, I will show you the level of madness. Then David one day, he discovered that his problem was too much. He said, this madness, because God had just killed one of his members when they're taking the ark. Then the ark went to the house of Obed-Edom the Gittite. So Bible says, in the house of Obed-Edom, the man began to prosper. The blessing was for David. He said, I will show you how. And that time in Israel, there was famine and there was death. He said, this demon is a liar. Say, Obed, prepare my thing, I'm coming. Took the ark and he began to dance. Cha, chua, eh. As he was singing, the famine disappeared. Celebration always brings manifestation. I see you about to celebrate. Your life is becoming better. That amen is not coming out well. Sound of abundance, you can say a better amen. Psalms 33:1 says what?
Rejoice in the Lord.
Rejoice, celebrate in the Lord.
All you righteous.
All you righteous.
For praise from
for
the
praise
from the upright.
From the upright
is beautiful.
Is beautiful. When they praise, when they upright praise, because this one is beautiful. Now imagine you're looking beautiful. You're looking ugly. And then you praise, you become beautiful. You don't need Mary Kay, you need Mary Praise. Praise always brings deliverance. Praise, anytime there is chronic praise, there is deliverance. Acts chapter 16:25. Bible says, at midnight, Paul prayed and sang praises. Now, this is the funny part. I say, and the other prisoners were listening. That's what some of you do. We are praising. You're wondering, what is this short man doing here? The other prisoners, what do you want? Read the Bible. 25 says what? Some of you, we are dancing. You're looking at us. Look at what happened.
But at midnight, Paul and Silas,
were praying
and singing hymns,
to God.
And the prisoners, were listening to them.
Look at you. As we are praising, you're staring. Listen, there are participators and spectators. Do you know what? Spectators are not paid. It's only participators that are paid. You can go to a football match. Only 12, 24 people are playing. And the stadium is full of 100,000 people. Only the 24 will be paid. Some of you, you glue on TV, you're watching Barcelona. And the Messi is earning money as you're watching. The man is gathering wealth as you're what? A spectator. It is a participator that is rewarded.
Yeah.
Look at what happened to them as they were singing. Continue. Says what?
Suddenly. There was a great earthquake. So that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately
all the doors were open
and everyone's chains were loosed.
Read on.
And the keeper of the prison, awaking from sleep, and seeing the prison doors open, supposing the prisoners had fled, drew his sword, and was about to kill himself.
Read on.
But Paul called with a loud voice, saying, do yourself no harm, for we are all here.
See, if you read down the scriptures, the only people who went out of prison was Paul and Silas. Though because of the praise of Paul and Silas, all the gates were open. The rest could not run because it was not their deliverance. The prison warden came and said, Paul and Silas, come. Bible says he took them to his house and gave them bread. The rest, their doors open because God said, you did not praise. I will make sure your legs can't move. Stay there. So that is why anyone that today will engage in celebration, will engage in praise, you are coming out of your challenge. That the man can be louder. Number two, how do I rejoice? How do I celebrate? By making joyful, crazy noise. Bible says, make a joyful shout to the Lord. Noise. God loves noise. He said in Psalm 150, verse 4, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Now, it's only the dead that can praise. Now, us, we are not in the mortuary, we are in the sanctuary. So we must give God noise.
Amen.
Say noise.
Noise.
One of the things I will do, I'll make sure we have very loud speaker. I like noise. One time we were doing prayer point here on a Friday or a Wednesday. Power, we were praying. Then a man was passing. He had to die, catch fire, die. He said, who are these dying? The man said, he went across the road. And he said, I was afraid of moving lest I die. So I stood. People are saying, die. I'm not dying. So he said, I'm not moving. So the man, when the dying ends, he climbed stairs and sat behind. He said, let me join them. Then I'm not among the dead. He sat there. So after service, I was going out. He shook my hand. He said, man of God, will I die? I said, you will not die. I said, why are you saying that? He said, how do you pray? Die. And if God allowed me to hear die, it means I'm going to die. So I came up that I may not. So thank God for noise. It is noise that gave us a member.
Somebody make a joyful noise to the Lord. Psalms 98. Oh. Hey! You must love to make noise. Noise is good. Anytime you don't make noise, know you're dead. Yeah, can I read? Verse 88 from verse number 4.
Psalm 98, 4.
Uh-huh.
Shout joyfully to the Lord.
Shout joyfully to the Lord.
All the earth.
All the earth.
Break forth in song.
Break forth in song.
Rejoice.
Rejoice.
And sing praises.
And sing praises. Break forth. Some of you are too reserved. No, me, I'm a gentleman. Gentlemen die gently. Gentlemen die. Since the day of John the Baptist till now, the kingdom of God suffers. So if you want to die gently, that be a gentleman. But if you must make it, that's why I say yes, the women must learn to talk. If you talk, you secure your future. Am I talking? See, in life, noise is important. You know why today I'm a preacher? In school, I was a noise maker. I didn't know I was training for pulpit. I became prefect because of a noise making. The teacher go come, Akama! I say, yes, sir. I had a noise maker's list. I said, sir, I can't miss. I always took punishment because I was always making. How can everybody else be quiet? I will not be quiet. Quiet means I consent. I don't consent with them. See, so I used to open my mouth and just talk, piam piam. I didn't know God is calling me. See, I make noise, then I increase salary. What is making noise? Make me wear suit. Noise is important. And the suit is talking in tongues. So it's because sometimes mama tells me when you're preaching, you make noise. Correct. Now that's where I must make noise. Lastly, how do I rejoice? Tell neighbor with the dance. Tell neighbor with the dance. How do I celebrate with what? That's where we are good. If you don't dance, you see fire. So out of abundance, we like shaking our body. That's why we are not overweight. We are slim.
Amen.
We are what? We are divas. Diva. Because if you eat food every day, come on Sunday, you shake it off. So 5 kg will go down, will drop. That's why we have praise. Then we have high praises. So you must praise then praise high. You cannot go down. Exodus 15:20. Look at what Moses told the children of Israel. And look at what their daughters did. In the wilderness. They were in the wilderness. Verse 20 says what?
Then Miriam.
The prophetess.
The sister of Aaron. Took the timbrel in her hand. And all the women.
Went after her.
With timbrels.
And with dances. They went out. Women began that in the wilderness. No wonder the Lord gave them manna.
Yeah.
Because a dance provokes God. 2 Samuel 6:40 says what?
Then David danced before the Lord.
With all his strength.
And David was
look
wearing
at me.
A
David did not do a. He did not move his leg as if a tree about to fall. He danced with strength. Everything in him was dancing. And God loved it. Say, correct. David, correct. You're coming to church. David, your example. Who are you copying? You come to church, you cannot dance. You're behaving too spiritual. And we know you're a liar. We know you're a thief. We know you. But you come into church, you want to pray holy. Oh yeah, dance! Abba. David used his strength to dance. Psalms 149 verse 3. Now, look at me.
abundance comes from the word abundance. Dance has been derived from the word abundance. So, where there is abundance, there is a dance. And where there is a dance, it will provoke abundance. If you must see abundance, you must dance. Read for me. Psalms 149 verse 3 to 4.
Let them praise his name.
Let him praise his name.
With a dance.
With a dance.
Let them sing praises
Let
to him.
Let them sing praises to him.
With a timbrel.
With a timbrel.
And harp.
And harp.
For the Lord takes pleasure in his people.
When his people dance, he takes pleasure. Yeah.
He will beautify
he
the
will
humble.
Beautify the humble.
With salvation.
When you dance, you're showing God how humble you are. It's only the proud who cannot dance. You say me with my dignity. Do not have PhD. Me, do you know how where I live, what I drive? You're proud, so you can't be charged. You just even your fingers, you don't want to hit them hard because they are the ones that sign check. God say, I'll show you. See, anytime you dance, you're humble. Imagine David the king dancing before the maiden, he was humble. David, a whole king, dancing. You, what do you have to draw to dance? I need to dance to get up there. Tell your neighbor, you must learn to dance. Stop behaving like that. Pull down your brow, your pride. You will go down. You're proud. When you dance, it means this is how humble I am. There's nothing that moves me. Nothing. I'm a humble man. I can put down my ego, my car, my suit, and dance. I'm not before men, I'm before God. And before God, I'm nothing. Yes. So why should I behave as if I know it? Let me really put it down. And God says he beautifies the meek. He beautifies them. He makes them beautiful. You look lovely. You look favored. He say, how can my beautiful daughter be sick? You can't be sick. I've seen your humility. Because he resisted the proud and he gives grace to the humble. When you dance, you're humble. So you receive what? Grace.
Amen.
Jeremiah 31:4.
Again. I will build you.
I will build you.
And you shall be rebuilt.
And you shall be rebuilt.
O virgin of Israel.
O virgin of Israel.
You shall again be adorned.
You shall again be adorned.
With your tambourine.
With your tambourine.
And shall go forth in dances.
And shall go forth in dances.
Of those who rejoice.
Of those who rejoice. Say, I shall rebuild you. When I rebuild you, I want you to dance. You shall go forward and dance. Listen to me. Listen. Anytime you dance, God gives an open check.
Amen.
He gives you what? Open check. Anytime you dance, God gives you what? An open check. Can I prove to you?
Yes.
Go to Matthew 14. Matthew what? 14. Are you there? Verse 6 up to 9.
But when Herod's birthday was celebrated,
the daughter of Herodias,
danced before them,
came and danced before the father,
and pleased Herod,
and pleased his father.
Therefore, he promised with an oath.
Then the father promised with an oath
to give her whatever she
and say,
ask.
I'm giving you an open check. Say whatever you want, even half of my kingdom. Is it also?
Yes.
He said, my daughter, you have only danced. I'm happy. Ask. I'm giving you an open check. But the daughter had a wicked mother. Wicked what?
Yeah.
Read.
So she, having been prompted by her mother.
Prompted by her mother.
Said. Give me John the Baptist.
Give me the head of the prophet, John the Baptist.
Here on a platter. And the king was sorry.
And the king said, what? Read on.
Nevertheless.
Nevertheless.
Because of the oath.
Because of the open check, the oath.
And because of those who sat with him, he commanded it to be given to her.
He said, bring the prophet's head down for my daughter. Why? She only danced. Aye. Anytime you dance, God say, ask anything. Ask anything. Do you know when David danced, the wife Michal said, look at the king. How he's embarrassing himself. And David answered and told her, it is through this dance that the Lord gave me the kingdom of your father.
Amen.
So your father could not dance. Me, I danced and I got it. If you want to take your neighbor's break to the one sitting next to you, just dance.
Amen.
Herod said, my daughter, what do you want? I said, my mother told me that, why did the mother ask for the head of the prophet? Because the prophet said, you have taken your brother's wife. Herod had taken Philip's, his brother's wife. So the man of God condemned Herod. So the wife was not happy because the man wanted to change his mind. Because Herod used to fear John the Baptist. And he took him as a prophet. So when the prophet told him, you, a wicked man, you have taken your brother's wife. Now Philip was struggling. And Herod, who's the king, wanted his wife. The wife said, I will not die in poverty. Let me die in wealth. I will move to the king's house. So the wife went to live with Herod because the brother of Herod was poor. So it was wrong. But the mother discovered, if this man continue living, he will convince this man who has money to take me back. He must die. So my daughter, if you dance and your father is happy, if he asks for anything, ask for the head of the prophet, because the prophet will finish my destiny. Are you hearing me? Anytime you dance, you're telling God, give me an open check. That's why you don't only dance, you dance with expectation. You don't dance, just dance with something. God, as I dance, let this pain go. As I dance, let money come. As I dance, let the wedding ring enter my finger. You dance with expectation.
I believe you've been blessed by this sermon. I believe your life has been changed. I believe your expectation has been met. And I believe you're about to experience the manifestation of God. After today, I want you to know that your life has changed. I want you to know that things are becoming better in your life. If you do what I've taught, if you manifest them, if you practice them. The Bible says, not only the hearers of the word, but the doers. As you do these things, you'll experience the grace and the blessings of God. Second, listen to me. You cannot celebrate God who is not your Lord. So what do? You need to come and give your life to the Lord. Why don't you repeat this prayer after me? Say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I give you my heart. I give you my soul. And I give you my life. From today, change my life. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that I'm born again. Wonderful. If you've made that prayer, welcome to the family of God. Look for a wonderful church, of which I would recommend. Why don't you visit Hand of Abundance Church? I would like to be your pastor, your mentor, and your father in the Lord. I would like to stand with you and pray with you. Please feel free to call these numbers for any inquiry or any prayer request. The number is 0727-438-728. 0727-438-728. Or 0728-86-43-44. You can also visit us on Facebook, Rev B, Akama, and Sound of Abundance Church. And you can also go to our YouTube and just like Rev Akama, and then you'll get all our messages that will be a blessing to you. I hope to see you in church for midweek service, and your life will have blessing again. God bless you. Till I meet you again, always remember, as long as you're not dead, there's hope for you tomorrow.
The chasm is far too wide.